Welcome to this tutorial series. Each part of this series will cover different aspects of creating games in HypeHype. And by the end, we will have created a 3D exploration game together. In this video, we're going to take a look at how to get started. Now, from your feed, you can remix any game by tapping the icon on the top right and pressing Remix This Hype at the bottom of the screen. Or you can go to the Create page by tapping the plus icon at the bottom of your screen. Here, you can select from a wide variety of different templates, you can access interactive tutorials in our app, and you can view game jams and other ongoing events. Today, we are going to start from scratch. Now we are in the editor. You can move around by swiping, or you can rotate the camera by swiping with two fingers. You can always return to the view of the active game camera by pressing Reset View from the left. Tap objects to select them, and when they are selected, a gizmo will appear around it. With the three icons at the bottom, you can switch between different transform modes. You can move, you can rotate, and you can scale. And you can drag the colored handles to make changes on a single axis like this. In the bottom, we have a selection context menu. This contains different kinds of actions that you can do to the selected object. For example, here you can duplicate or you can delete. When anything is selected, the details panel is going to appear at the top right, and you can expand it by pressing the drawer icon. In the basic tab, you can make changes to the object's visual or physical properties. So for example, we can turn this cube blue by tapping on green here and choosing a nice blue color. The advanced details panel is where you can edit logic nodes that are embedded into the object, but we are going to go through this in a later tutorial. On the left, we already looked at the quick menu when we were discussing the camera. This also holds additional options related to the camera, as well as snapping and a few other things. You can customize this by tapping the three dots at the top. From here, you can drag something onto the menu, or you can reorder the menu by long pressing, like this. Along the bottom of the screen, we have the toolbar. Here, you're going to be able to find anything you need for making a level or creating logic. Just above that on the right, we can tap Assets, and this is going to open up the asset library. Here you can find a wide variety of different objects or music or sounds. We even have some pre-made assets that come with logic already applied to them. Now on the bottom right, you can playtest your game from the green button. For now, we're going to save our draft. We can do this from the top right, the Save button. And if you have not yet taken a thumbnail, it will automatically take one from the game camera view. And from here, you can adjust it however you like. Let's crop it nicely. There we go. Done. And you don't have to stress about this too much because you can always take new thumbnails or even upload your own one. Now let's give this game a name and a short description. These also do not have to be final because you can come back and edit them at any time. Once you're done, just tap the Save button at the bottom and your draft will be saved. Now that we have a saved draft of the game, we can come back to this in the next tutorial where we're going to be talking about working with objects in the HypeHype editor. I hope you enjoyed this introduction to the HypeHype editor. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next tutorial. And don't forget to check out the links down below to stay up to date with everything that we are doing. In the basic tab, you can make changes to an object related to its physical or... And it holds additional options. I wanted to say objects again. Guess what? I wasn't screen recording. Access interactive tutorials in the map. In the what? You can move, you can rotate, and you can drag. What? I was reading the next sentence. I'm sorry. Undo, 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 undo. Okay, that was too difficult for me.